mastered this alchemic circle as base metals to the Philosopher's Stone and transmute. He woke up, looked at the bright morning star, did his routine, then 2 hours later is in his car pumping. Debalor is very special as he starts driving alone. What is he looking for on the road of life? There are passengers and drivers, some will speak the truth, but most dudes are liars. Very few do control their desires. Most people live diving into pools of fire. One day the morning star, a great musician, fell down or got kicked out of heaven. Bear the light. Anyway, homie, let's ride, bear the right. Then the left, the tongue has the power of life and death. Words cause and decks to exist. Speak what's not as if it is. He then gets off his car and starts walking. We walk by faith and sight. Faith is formed by repetitive perceptions. A seed planted and watered will harvest. Seek and you will find. Believe when you pray and received it. But what will you get? This truth is confusing and grazed. Venusian, reptilian, aliens, angels, gods, and demons. This bright morning star, her beauty, all can see it. A goddess, when she walks down the street, men become enchanted. Mars start crashing. Peep how the chakras align with the planets. He knocks on the door and access is granted by Janet, who asks, are you ready to have this power from chanting? Yes, was his answer. He was eager yet very nervous. The ritual begins. He'll be one of them soon. Then Gregorian chants they start listening to. While chanting, a portal begins to open. The sister grabs his hand and the two slowly stroll in. The door closes behind them when they enter. And they walk with the music of Ezekiel, thinking, wouldn't it be cool if he could stay forever? Don't be conformed, but transformed by constant mind renewal. Examine every thought, intentions. When two frequencies are alike, they gain equivalence of form. Every action is a magnet attracting and repelling. The law states that by changing your frequencies, nouns, opportunities come and go. The laws are, mystery creates an image which spawns desire or repulsing. He was dead before this, but then he had died. Like Kenny at South Park, he'd wake up the next day alive. And this kept happening, so he kept battling. Living in a cell with himself, he was wrestling. He hid the truth, but really wasn't listening. Plus, he never enjoyed wasted dividends. And time, truth went unapplied, life was whipping him. Look at how this prodigal son is living when he belongs on the throne more than philosophers don't help others. Get free from the prison inside the dome and discover life's beauty and wonder together with one chasing their dreams like tag, you're it. The race ain't given to the swift, but to those who persist, eyes in the invisible. Paid little or no attention to the visible. When Venus kissed him, he began living because people perish with this no vision. The greater the risk, the greater the reward. The greater the risk, the greater the downfall. When he got free, he still couldn't see because his eyes were disguised by his fantasies. He was blind like most of us, but gradually he gained sight and insight on reality. Deny facts, forget the past, press toward the goal, fully armored, sword in hand. Now he's in another dimension with a sister named Penelope, who teaches him telekinesis and mental telepathy. First meditate to elevate celestial energies, only then was he given the ability to see, because before this, all this insight came from the five senses. Everything in the universe is one and the same, from galaxies to humans to mountains, winds, Bluetooth signals. So, how do you define what's real? Man must constantly edit his lens, meaning how he perceives, refocusing with the challenges and changes of life, accepting an unbiased reality. Only then can he see. Man develops a screen, a sixth sense, connecting him to an upper reality, to receive divinity and let go of ego. Man, spiritually and scientifically, is a microcosm of the ocean and the universe. Challenge every day.